Hi friends, welcome back. Today we are going to solve Code Forces problem dinner with Emma. So before we go through the problem description and the solution, I just want to mention that my channel is dedicated to help people who are preparing for Java interviews or coding interviews. On my channel, you will find more than 200 solved coding problems that were taken from big tech company interviews such as Amazon, Facebook, Microsoft, Apple, Google, and many other financial companies. And those coding questions are selected to cover important coding varieties such as graph problems, binary search tree related problems, dynamic programming related coding interview questions, as well as BFS, DFS, matrix related problems. Also, coding problems for linked list as well as string related coding interview questions are also covered and explained with examples in Java. So if you are preparing for Java interviews or coding interviews, please subscribe to this channel now. This channel can definitely help you in your job interview preparation. So please subscribe it. So let's look into the dinner with Emma problem. So Jack decides to invite Emma out for a dinner. Jack is a modest student. He doesn't want to go with an expensive restaurant, and Emma is a girl with high taste. She prefers elite places. Manhattan consists of N streets and M avenues. There is exactly one restaurant on the intersection of each street and avenue. The streets are numbered with integers from 1 to N, and the avenues are numbered with from 1 to M. The cost of dinner in the restaurant at the intersection of the ith street and jth avenue is Cij. So Jack and Emma decide to choose a restaurant in the following way. Firstly, Emma will choose the street to dinner, and then Jack will choose the avenue, right? Emma and Jack makes their choice optimally. So Emma wants to maximize the cost for the dinner and Jack wants to minimize it. Emma takes into account that Jack wants to minimize the cost of the dinner. So find the cost of the dinner for the couple in love. So this is what the problem statement says. So Jack actually wants to minimize the cost and Emma wants to maximize it, right? And firstly, Emma will start choosing the street and Jack will start choosing the avenues, right? So a matrix will be given to us, right? As you can see here. So 3 is a three streets, which is in the matrix, it is 3 rows basically, right? And 4 is 4 number of columns in the matrix, right? So columns is basically avenues and rows is streets, right? So that's what given to us. So that's what the input and input is mentions, right? So the output is the minimum cost that Jack has to pay actually, right? So as you can see, Jack has to pay for this example, minimum cost is 2, right? So let's take this example over here so we can understand what the problem is. So this is our first example, which is in red color, and so we'll first go through this example. So as you can see, Emma will first choose the streets, right? So she will have to choose the street where she want to go for a dinner, right? So for example, if she choose this street, right, first street, then Jack has to choose the avenue. Avenues are columns basically, right? And streets are rows, right? So this is Emma. Emma will choose the rows basically, means streets, and this is Jack, right? And Jack will choose the column of the matrix, right, which are avenues, right? Because at the intersection there is a restaurant, right? So if Emma chooses this first row, then Jack will choose optimally, right? So Jack will choose 1, right? In that case, if Emma chooses this row, then again Jack will choose optimally. So Jack can choose this one, right? Because he want to minimize the cost, right? And in case of this one, if Emma chooses this middle street, right, then Jack has to choose any of this one. He can choose, but he has to pay 2 as the cost, right? Whatever he choose, he has to, minimum cost he has to pay is 2. So whenever we will have to basically to solve this problem, whenever Emma chooses any street, Jack has to choose the minimum from that street, right? So what we can do is we can go from this matrix row by row, and we will travel right complete row by row, and we will always keep track of what is the minimum in that row basically, right? So we will always keep track of minimum basically in that row, right? So for example, if you see, you know, minimum will be 1 here in this case, right? So if Emma chooses this first row, then minimum is 1. If Emma chooses the second one, then the minimum will be 2, right? Then we have to put 2 here. We will not be having 1 in this case. Minimum will go to 2, right? So we will find minimum in this row basically, right? And we will update our minimum, right? So minimum will be the maximum from this one basically, right? Basically, so in this case the minimum will be 2. So minimum in all these rows basically, right? So here it is 1, here it is 2, and here it is 1, right? So in this case, if Emma chooses the second one, then we have to first find out minimums, and we have to find out maximum in those minimum basically, right? So minimums, maximum in the minimum, so which means that maximum between, we will find 1, 2, 1, right? 1, 2, 1. So it is equal to maximum, it will be equal to 2, right? So if she chooses this second row, right, second row, then Jack has to pay 2 as his cost basically, right? So that's why you will see 2 as the answer here, right? 2 as the answer, as you can see here. So we will again take a look at the second example that is given to us, so you will understand it more. So let's just go through the second example now. So this is the second example. So what we have decided, we will go row by row and we will keep calculating the minimum, and we have to take maximum in those minimums, right? Maximum in those minimums. So first row minimum is 1, right? Then second row the minimum is this one, right? So this is the one which is minimum in first row, this is the one minimum in second row, and third row also this is the one which is minimum in the third row, right? So maximum of all these things will be 1 basically, right? 1. So 1 will be the answer, right? Because, and why it works, because whatever row Emma will choose, Jack will always choose the optimal column, right? So he will always choose the column which has the least, like least cost basically, right? So that's why 1 will be the answer. So as you can see, like here 1 will be the answer, right? So one more time, I'll just explain you how we are solving it. So we will go through the matrix row by row. So this row, then this row, then this row, and we will always keep calculating the maximum in those minimums, right? So that is what the approach is. So let's just take a look at the implementation. So I just created the first example, right? 3, 4, and this is the matrix that is given to us, right? And minimum cost will be 0 in the beginning. So we will go through the each row, right? So this is the row, and we will initialize this minimum is equal to integer dot max value, and we will try to find out minimum in that row, right? Minimum in that row. And we will always take math.max of maximum cost that minimum cost that we found so far, and this mean, right? This mean and the minimum cost we found so far. So that's what I explained you, that we will find maximum between this minimum cost. So that's what we are doing here, right? So we will keep going through all the rows here, and we will always keep looking for the minimum cost in that row, and we will always take the maximum between the minimum cost we have seen so far and the minimum cost in this row, correct? So this is what will give us the minimum cost. So let us run this example with this code with this example. So result is 2, right? Result is 2 here, as you can see. So this is the example that we have run, right? So this is the example that we have run with result 2 basically, right? So now we will create another example with this one, and we will rerun the code. So it should give us 1. So 1, 2, 3. So let me just create it quickly, you know, while you, so it's like a 1, 2, 3. Then the next one is 2, 3, 1. So next one is 2, 3, 1. And the next one is 3, 1, 2, right? 3, 1, 2. So this is 3, 1, 2, and number of columns and number of rows both are same here, 3, right? So let me just do formatting here. So now we will just run our code. So it should give us 1 as the answer. So it is giving us 1 as the answer, which is correct for the second example. So our code is running fine with both these examples. So this is how you can solve dinner with Emma problem. So it's just like a matrix traversal, and you have to understand this logic of how we have to go through row by row and keep calculating the minimum, and then we will take maximum from them basically, right? So if you haven't already gone through my playlist on my channel, there are playlists for LeetCode, LeanCode solutions as well as CodeForces solutions. And those playlists discusses important varieties of problem from coding interview perspective from big tech companies, such as dynamic programming, graph problems, binary search tree problems, linked list related coding interview questions, as well as string related coding interview questions. It also has important matrix related problems to demonstrate BFS and DFS, how it works on 2D grids and matrix, how to find out optimal paths with maximum cost, minimum cost, how to find out number of paths from source to destination. All these kind of different varieties is covered there. Also, if you are looking for a telephonic interview in Java, and that there is a playlist called as Java interview, that has, you know, frequently asked Java telephonic interview questions, and how to answer those telephonic questions is also explained there. And those questions are taken from big tech companies like Amazon, Apple, Facebook, Microsoft, Google. So those were telephonic and initial round of coding, Java interview questions. So it will give you a lot of good practice material for your interviews. If you like this video helpful, how the, you know, problem statement is explained with examples and code, then please hit like and subscribe this video. Your subscription is really important for the channel, because that is the way the video can reach to more people like you, who are preparing for Java interviews, coding interviews, as well as learning different Java concepts and Java architectural API related videos. So, you know, they can also look into these solved problems, and they will also understand, you know, how to approach different varieties of problems, which techniques to use, what data structures to use to solve those kind of problems. Because the main goal of the channel is to help people, you know, who are preparing for Java and J2E interviews by providing them some kind of real videos and explaining them, so it can be helpful for them. So please subscribe for the channel, and if you like this video, please share it with your friends and colleagues, and thanks for watching this video.